Another ship in Brook. Storm here in Norway. So today's project is gonna get this tractor ready for some snow blowing, and I have to install the snow chains. That's not gonna be very fun in this weather. I'm gonna have to use the little snow blower to get the big tractor out. It starts to build up pretty much snow. I'm gonna let it warm up for about 5 minutes. Meanwhile, the tractor is warming up. I'm gonna try to free up my car. This is not a Lamborghini, although it looks like it now. It's actually a Volkswagen bus. when you use this method, very important you don't take the rope where the valve is. You don't want to break the valve in this weather. Remember about once you start driving, you have to tighten this more. Just take it for a spin and give it some more tightness. I'm not tightening this yet because I want to drive it a little bit and tighten some more. Now I will drive it back and forth a couple of times, and then I can tighten the chains and secure all the fittings. Now I can just secure all the fittings. And I do this on all the chains. On this style of fittings, I use a steel wire to secure it. Just make sure this is not coming in contact with the tire. Okay, so now this is finally ready for some snow blowing. I should have installed the chains a little bit for this weather, but I didn't have time this year. But that's not a problem now. Now the chains are on. The chute just jammed up. It's very wet snow underneath the new snow. It's minus 6 degrees now, but this storm started with rain and it's so wet the snow under. So this just jammed up. I'm gonna take off this guard. Now the share pin broke. The share pin on the axle just broke. This is the one that broke. It is 10 millimeters. And always make sure you have some spare of these ones. Because if you don't have this, you won't be able to use your blower. This is the right size. It's freezed. It freezed together. It's always something. This is the bolt, and it's meant to break if it's any hard resistance. Okay, so now that's fixed. And as I said, always keep some extra shear pins for all your equipment. It's the next day and we had some more snow this night, and the wind is really picking up. This is day 3 of this storm, and the tractor is very frozen. So I'm gonna use a block heater for a couple of hours before I try to even start it. Everything is frozen up. I'm gonna have this on for a couple of hours. It's a couple of days later and finally we got some better weather. Today it is 3 degrees Celsius and I have to re-tighten the chains. Okay, so you see the tractor does a good job to move all the snow. But when it is so much snow, this tractor gets a little bit too small. It's only 85 horsepower. So we have to go very slow when you use the blower. And you can also use a loader like I showed you now. But that takes a lot of time. I usually prefer just to use the blower. But the loader works very good when I want to go into inside corners. Like here when I try to dig out my trailer. And the snow is up to about 1.5 meter. And it's a very, very heavy snow. These blocks are very heavy. I couldn't imagine to dig this out by hand. That would take forever. Once again, the chute clogged up. That's a very common problem when the snow gets wet. And this tractor doesn't have the power to push it through. So it just clogs up the chute. One way to prevent this happening is to take off the guard. And then just have to scoop out all this heavy snow. But never do this while the tractor is running. I'm pretty sure if I painted this again, that would prevent this from happening that often. And once you get all the snow out, you have to make sure the impeller is free. Yes, everything is spinning freely. So if you would just start it up, you can break the share pins. But now everything is free. Okay, that worked just fine. So if you ever consider buying a tractor for snow removal, I would suggest to buy one with at least 100 horsepower, especially if you're gonna snowblow. The snowblower just sucks out the energy out of the tractor. This one is a bit too small for these conditions, so I have to go very, very slow with the snowblower. But it gets the job done. I'm gonna end the video here. I also have some other snowblower videos you can watch as well. So I see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.